What's going on, Wolfpack Nation? Welcome back to a new video. In today's video, I want to talk about a few things. First was, of course, the tough and frustrating loss to North Carolina a few weeks ago in Chapel Hill. I also wanted to touch on some recruiting that happened in both basketball and football over the past few weeks or so. Haven't touched on recruiting in a while. And also preview tonight's game against Miami at home. So I guess first we'll start off, and I want to keep this short. I don't want to spend too much time on this. We'll talk about the loss to Carolina. Lost 48-21. It was just a frustrating game from start to finish. State started Bailey Hockman at quarterback. It was obvious they had no trust in him on a couple of third downs. They went to the Wildcat. Even on third and short, they did not trust Hockman to throw the ball at all. And as I suggested in the previous video, I figured Coach Dorn would go to freshman quarterback Ben Finley, and he did do that when State trailed 14-0 in the first half. And on his first drive, it just seemed like State had a spark on offense. They moved the ball quick. They went that no-huddle 10-back system. It got them down the field, made some great throws. But, of course, that play in the end zone, a great play design, Finley put it on the money, it just dropped and tipped up in the air, and it was picked. And that seemed like that just was the sum. It's the summary of NC State sports, to be honest with you. And it was the summary of the game. State was crawling back into the game, and that was tough. But State did get a break on a missed field goal, and they came back down the field, and Finley threw a strike to Amezi, who scored. So State, at that point in the game, should have been tied, but State was still trailing 7-14. And then we go to the second half. Finley was picked off on a tip pass. And it just seemed like the offense stalled once again. A couple turnovers by Finley, and they went back to Bailey Hockman, who he looked better than he did in the first half. But Carolina, I believe, did have some backups in on defense. Again, State's defense struggled through the whole from start to finish through the whole game. Poor tackling. Their running backs Carter and Williams ran all over State's D-line. The whole defense, they ran over them. Breakdowns in coverage the whole game. Defense played horrible. From start to finish, they have to be better, and especially against a Miami team that's great on both running and passing that they played tonight. And I can't say my prediction was obviously very wrong. I own up to it, but I mean, I can't pick against State, especially against North Carolina. I don't think I can ever pick against State, no matter who's involved and who's playing. I just can't do it. But I can admit it was wrong, and we'll try to be better next game. Now, let's get rid of that game, forget it, and let's move over. Before we touch on the Miami game tonight, let's talk about some recruiting first. In football, NC State landed a commitment a couple weeks ago from four-star safety Chase Hadley. And this is a really solid pickup. Chase had offers from teams like Oklahoma and South Carolina, and he picked State. He's an in-state guy, so it's good to see keeping talent in the state of North Carolina. And he's an athlete. He can play probably linebacker, corner, or safety on defense. He's got great ball skills. A very, very good athlete for his size. And just a really good pickup for State. And it continues to build that recruiting class. It's really an underrated class. I think four stars now coming in. Along in that defense with Chevalier Price, Jordan Poole, and just a lot of underrated talent coming for NC State's next recruiting class. So nice to have Chase Hadley on board. Moving on over to basketball recruiting now, NC State landed 3-star point guard Brian Pass out of Reidsville, North Carolina over the past month or so. And Brian is another guy added to that solid class. He joins in the backcourt to Quavion Smith, as well as Ernest Ross, the power forward who committed. The 2 4-stars and now a 3-star for the 2022 class for Coach Keats. And this is a guy Coach Dorn was targeting in football. He was a 3-star wide receiver, but decided he wanted to play basketball at the next level. And who knows, he may decide he wants to play football, and he very well can. He's a great athlete, and he could play wide receiver as well as point guard for NC State. So it's a nice pickup for potentially 2 sports, and glad to have Brian joining the pack. Sticking with basketball, NC State made the top 5 for 4-star center Roosevelt Wheeler. He's a 4-star out of the state of Virginia. Number 2 ranked player in Virginia. Is a great big, and he'd be a big time pickup for State's 2021 class, who already features 3 really talented players. Coach Keese is going to be in a recruiting battle. If State looks the same, seems to be in the top maybe favorite or maybe in the top 2 for him right now, but they're going to have to work hard because LSU, VCU especially, and Louisville are going to pursue him to the end. And it's going to be a tough get for State, but they seem to be in great position, and he would definitely be a big pickup. Now on to tonight's game against number 11 ranked Miami, 5-1 Miami. They come in as a 10.5-point favorite over NC State. State will have a chance to get a big-time upset win at home, but it won't be easy. They haven't beat Miami since 2008, and it'll be the first time even playing them since 2016. State will get a key piece back on the offensive line. Justin Witt will return this week from injury. It's a big get back for State. I know they've had a lot of guys out with injury, of course. Last year, we know how that went. I'd expect to see Bailey Hockman get the start at quarterback for NC State, but I would not be surprised. And I kind of expect that we'll see Ben Finley at some point for the Pack. But the key will be if NC State's defense can hold up against Miami's solid offense. That includes their star quarterback, De'Aaron King, who is a dual-threat guy, over 1,400 yards passing, 300 rushing so far in the season, 13 total touchdowns. He's been explosive in both the pass and the run. And they do great in balancing their run and pass offense. And State has had trouble tackling on defense, as we've seen. And their secondary, which has improved, has still struggled at times as well, breaking down coverages, as we seen last week or 2 weeks ago against Carolina. And just like NC State, Miami is also coming off of bye weeks. Both teams will be refreshed and ready to go here tonight. Now breaking down the prediction, Miami's final game or last game, they beat Virginia 19-14. State also, you know, they played Virginia and handled them very well. Virginia's got a lot healthier. They got their quarterback back, and they did beat Carolina last week. So when I thought about my prediction, both teams healthy, Miami a solid team. So I'm going to have to make this prediction. I'm going to say Miami 37-21 over NC State. Obviously, I hope it's wrong. Obviously, I hope State pulls out a win. But Miami seems to be a really solid team. It's just hard to pick against them, especially against the State team right now, who is really struggling on both sides of the football and so much uncertainty of who's going to be a quarterback and if the defense can step up to stop this solid Miami offense. But if you did enjoy this video, make sure you hit that like button for me. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Hopefully, State can pull out a win tonight. We'll see what happens. But as always, go Pack. Thank you for watching.